Mahashivaratri Satsang. Shivaratri is a very auspicious day, auspicious night for celebrity. Shiva means auspiciousness. Shiva means auspiciousness. Okay. Today is the auspicious night. Of all the nights in the year, Shivaratri night is most auspicious because tonight the cosmos showers us with the energy. Energy which helps us, which elevates us, which helps us to realize our own self, is Shiva. At the cosmic level, Shivaratri is the day, Shivaratri is the night, and the divine grace, energy is showered on the spiritual seekers. So from that perspective, today is very auspicious night. Who is Shiva? What is the significance of staying awake throughout the night and meditating, contemplating on Shiva? Shiva is none other than our higher self. Shiva is my self. My Atma is called Shiva. Shiva is not far away somewhere in the mountain. Shiva is not far away in some other loka, some other planet. Shiva is your own inner nature, your own inner self. The nature of our inner self is auspiciousness, bliss, existence, consciousness, all mean same thing, which is Shiva, which is our inner self. To contemplate on Shiva, to meditate on Shiva, to recognize Shiva as my inner self is called Shivaratri. Not only Shiva is my inner self, Shiva is this inner self of all the people. All the living beings are nothing but manifestation of Shiva. Shiva is in the heart of every living being. Recognition of Shiva in my heart as my essence, recognition of Shiva as the essence of all living beings is Shivaratri. When I recognize Shiva in my heart, Shiva as myself, Shiva is my Atma, I attain absolute peace. The deepest peace is experienced when Shiva is recognized as your self. Shiva is my Atma, myself. When we recognize that, we attain deep peace. When Shiva is recognized as the self of everybody, when Shiva is recognized as the presence in everybody, then there is a deep love. Peace is recognition of Shiva as myself. My inner self is Shiva. This recognition is called peace. Shiva is the self of every living being. Shiva is the self of living and non-living. This recognition leads to experience of love, the deepest love. the love which is universal in nature. This is the meaning of bhakti and jnana. Bhakti means love. Love for whom? Love for the God, love for the divine, love for the supreme reality. But can we recognize supreme reality without recognizing that ultimate principle, that supreme reality in myself? What I don't experience in myself, I cannot experience anywhere. So first I have to recognize the Shiva in me. Shiva has to be recognized as myself. That's the first step. That's called self-realization or self-recognition. Without recognizing Shiva in you, you cannot recognize Shiva anywhere else also. Okay? So recognize Shiva in your, as your essence, as your own self. And then you attain the supreme peace. That's called Parashanti. Parashanti or supreme peace is also called Mukti, freedom from disturbance. And one who attains that becomes a Jivan Mukta, or one who is liberated while he is alive. Mukti is not something which you get after death. Mukti is something which you can get while you are alive. And the only way to get Mukti is to recognize Shiva as your inner self. My inner self is Shiva. I am Shiva. Shivoham, Shivoham. This recognition has to happen. That's called Soham or Shivoham. This recognition alone can lead to Mukti or liberation. And Mukti or liberation means deepest peace or Parashanti. That doesn't end there. Recognize the presence of Shiva everywhere, in all living beings and non-living beings. When you start recognizing Shiva, then there is a universal love. That universal love is called bhakti. Okay? Shanti and bhakti. Bhakti is also called prema. Shanti and prema. These are two aspects of realization. Recognizing my own self as Shiva is called Mukti, and which leads to Shanti, Parashanti, deep peace. Recognizing Shiva everywhere, the presence of Shiva everywhere in living and non-living, leads to deep love, which is also called Bhakti or Prema. So there are two aspects of realization. One is recognition of self and recognition of this presence of the self in everywhere. So these two aspects. In another way I can say, as I go deep inside, I recognize myself, which is free from all attributes, from all characteristics. And this recognition requires jnana, the clarity, what I am and what I am not. Right now, I am in a state of a dream-like situation. I am in a dream-like situation. We are in a dream-like situation. This dream-like situation is called Maya, where I am considering myself as a body, mind, intellect, and a human being. In reality, we are not human beings. We are divine beings having a human body. When a human child is born, in reality, It's not a single child which gets born. Triplets are born. Three children are born at one time. So all of you, when you are born, you think you are born as a one child. Really, in reality, three children are born and the mother gives the birth to the child. All births are births of triplet. It's not single birth. What is this triplet? What is this triplet? The three children are based on the parenthood. Who are the parents? Mother and father contribute one cell each. One cell from the mother and one cell from the father come together and create a body. So the first child is the body which is coming from the father and mother, biological father and biological mother. So the biological father and biological mother give birth to the first child, which is your body. Where is the second child? The body has to be conscious. Father and mother can only give a physical body, physical form, because the cells are cells which come from father and mother, one each, they join together to create a physical body which grows. But the body, the physical body has to be alive. The physical body has to be living. The physical body has to be conscious. The consciousness comes from whom? Not from the father and mother. The consciousness comes from the supreme reality, Sadashiva. The supreme reality or pure consciousness called Sadashiva appears as consciousness in the body. This consciousness is called Chidabhasa or a reflected consciousness or manifested consciousness in your body. In this form, Shiva appears in your body as the consciousness. Where is that Shiva? See the aliveness in the body, the feeling of aliveness, the consciousness in the body, that is the presence of Shiva in your body. Shiva, who is everywhere, omnipresent Shiva, is called Sadashiva, appears in your body as the consciousness called Shiva. So this is the second child. The second child is divine child. The first child is the body. The second child is the divine child, Shiva consciousness appearing in the body. If the Shiva consciousness goes from the body, then the body becomes Shava, dead. Shiva makes the body alive. So that's why when somebody dies, the body is burnt. Shiva has, the consciousness has moved away. Shiva makes the body, which is Shava, a Jiva, alive. Okay. So second child is the divine consciousness which appears in the body. First child is born from the father and mother, which is called body. Second child is born from Sadashiva and Adi Parashakti and is called Shiva. Okay, now where is the third child? What happens to the third child? Where is the third child? Two children are understood. One is body, which is biological parents. The consciousness is spiritual parents, Sadashiva and Adiparashakti. Together give the second child. And I said triplets, okay? One more child is there. Where is that? The third child has many fathers. The third child has many fathers and mothers. Okay? The third child is called the mind. The consciousness is first child, which is from Parameshwara, Sadashiva. The consciousness is born, it's called Shiva. The second child is called body, which is coming from the parents, biological parents. The third child is called mind. Mind has many fathers and many mothers. How is that so? When the child is born, okay? When the child is born, how is the child? Innocent, peaceful, blissful. Right? And that's why we say children are God, of the form of God. They are not of the form of God, they are God only. When we say God, the real meaning of God is ananda, bliss. The children are embodiment of bliss. Because there are only two there now. Two children are there. One is biological parents and other is spiritual parents. Okay? Shiva and body, which is biological parents. So only two are there. Now, the third child gets born. That happens only after 11 days of the birth of the child. The day you give Namakarana to the child. You do a naming ceremony, no? So what is the naming ceremony doing? The child now is innocent and it doesn't know inside and outside. It is blissful. It is non-dual, Advaita sthiti. It's very, very blissful. Okay? The bliss is because it doesn't know separation. There is no separation between the child and the environment. So that's why it's blissful. The father and mother want the child to become like them. So they give the name to the child. And child starts understanding, oh, I am separate from this totality. So it starts recognizing itself, I am separate. Okay? So that is the beginning of the birth of the third child. Beginning only. Huh? It's just beginning. Okay? For that child, now everybody starts education. Right? What education? The mother gives education, the father gives education, the grandfathers gives education, the grandmother gives education, the television gives the education, the mobile phone gives the education, the friends gives the education, the school teacher gives the education. The more the education, the more the knowledge, more the knowledge, more the thoughts, the bliss is gone now. Bliss is replaced with the thoughts. Thoughts means mind. Please understand, when you are born, the mind is in a very, very rudimentary form. The society or the environment contributes to bloom that mind. Fills that mind with the thoughts. Fills that mind with the ideas, concepts. The moment thoughts and concepts come into your mind, the bliss disappears. So this is how the third child is born. What kind of education takes place from father and mother? Mother and father have their own dreams and ambitions. Okay? Explicitly or implicitly, through emotions, feelings, they get expressed and the child learns them. And mother and father learned their emotions and feelings from their ancestors. So, gradually the child is being programmed to become like a human being. Right now it's a divine child. Right? When the child is born, it's divine. It is Shiva Swarupi, Shiva only. Slowly, slowly you are making into a human. What it makes a human? Then you say, I ask the question, what it makes human? Don't you know? Emotions, feelings. The child had only one bliss. Now we are teaching that to make it human. Emotions, feelings, anger, okay, likes and dislikes. This gradually comes from the society, environment. So the mind grows. The third child is born. The third child is called the mind. And who is the father of this third child? Many fathers, many mothers. So you are not a one child, you are a triplet. Triplet. Wholesale three children are born. Okay. When the child is in the womb of the mother, the brain development starts at the month, at sixth month. When the child is in the month of mother's womb, by 6 months, the brain is forming. But when the brain is forming, it grows very rapidly, very fast. So between the age of 6 months in the mother's womb to 9 months, the brain formation is 50%. Very rapid growth is happening. And in that rapid growth, the child's learning is also more. Whatever learning, whatever emotions, feelings of the mother, whatever the way she responds to the environment, gets impressed on the soft brain which is developing. My child is born 9 months to 4 years, the brain grows by another 30%. It's also rapid growth. At that time, it learns from the father, mother, their behavior, their emotions, the society, the television, the grandparents, and the peer, it starts learning. Now, I'm not speaking of learning of English, mathematics, or physics, or language. I'm speaking of learning of the basic emotional patterns, basic behavioral patterns, which forms the foundation of your life. Okay? And these are very early learnings. Becomes very deep-rooted impressions. Between the age of 4 years to 9, so another 10% growth takes place. At this time, the education comes from the classmates and the teacher, their behavior, the way they respond, it gives you input. Between the age of 9 to 18, another 10% grows. Now the boy is growing his mush and the girl is becoming mature. So they learn from the opposite sex. So by the age of 18, your brain is formed 100%, but basic patterns of life is already learned. And please understand, this learning happens before you develop any discrimination of what is right, what is wrong. Right? So now you are saying, oh, this is right, this is wrong and all. That discrimination is not yet developing. You don't know. The child is absorbing everything from the environment. Whatever is fed to that, it absorbs. The discrimination has not developed. Okay? Before the discrimination develops, a lot of deep-rooted impressions are formed in the brain by the environment, and these deep-rooted impressions form the thought pattern, emotional pattern, and feeling. And in other words, it's called the mind. So the third child is born, it's called mind. So you are actually a wholesale three children. First is divine child, second is human child, third is societal child. Child of the society. So three children are born. out of these three children, the most silent one is the divine child. It doesn't make noise at all. It's always peaceful and doesn't make any noise. The other two children, out of the other two children, the maximum noise is made by the society's child. All likes and dislikes of the society, okay, anger and fear and emotions of society is inherited by the third child. Okay, so now understand that you are a combination of three: a divine child, a human child, and the society child. Shivaratri means recognizing that I am the divine child. Otherwise, your divine child is forgotten. The divine child is forgotten at all. You have become the society child. Or you have become the biological parent's child. Okay? Everywhere, in filling up your bio data, father's name, mother's name. Right? And everything, language and caste and all the things, is a society child. So, in your bio data, in your job application, wherever you're communicating, you're only very, very conscious about the human child and the society child. And nobody tells you about the divine child, which is you. When you are born as a divine child, but you grow up as a human child, then you become society's child. Out of these three, the divine child never grows because it's never born also. So divine child just appears to see what the hell is happening on this earth. Okay? It appears through your body just to observe. It came as a witness, sakshi, to see what is going on here. But the noise of this human child and noise of the society child, the divine child also forgets that I am the divine child. It starts behaving as if society's child. Okay? But nothing has happened to that. Divine child is divine child. But it is confusing itself now. It's confused now. Seeing this in a crowd, no? The three children are playing. One child starts crying. Other two children also start crying. Oh, looking at the one child, they start crying. So that's what's happening, these three children. The divine child also thinks, oh, I am in trouble. The society child is always in trouble. Society child is never. What? How can it not be trouble now? It's a child of multiple parents and multiple fathers, multiple mothers. It's a sort of orphan also. So it will always be trouble. Always in trouble. It keeps on crying. And with that, human child also cries and divine child also thinks, oh, that's also in trouble. Okay? So, the situation now, everybody is crying. Nobody knows who is crying for what. Everybody says, I am suffering. Okay? When you are born as a divine child. Actually, you are not born as a human child. Okay? You are born as a divine child. Very blissful. The bliss of the God was sent to you while you were birth. That is the gift, that is the grace, the real grace which has come to you. Now you ask for grace. When you started your life, enough grace was packaged into you. The grace means bliss. Enough. See, we pray for grace, meaning, please give me, oh Lord, give me grace. You don't understand the word of grace. The bliss is the grace which has been given in abundance to you in birth, by birth. That's why you are born as a divine child. And you start thinking as a human child the day Namakara is done. Till that time, you are a divine child only. Okay, so you have heard this, many of you buy this, nowadays most of the people do purchase through internet, right? Amazon.com, you purchase something?
Amazon.com, you order something and get it.
And when that comes, how does it come? A small piece, a small thing is packaged so well, very nicely, right? So that no damage can happen. Like that, when Bhagawan or Sadashiva sends you, he packages very nicely in the mother's womb. Well packaged in the mother's womb. Okay? Very nicely packaged. No damage can happen. And in the transit, you are very comfortable. No damage has happened. Food, breathing, nothing has to be done. Okay? So you are in a such a comfortable situation, and that is called ananda. So that time, your biological mother, the universal mother, Shiva Shakti, are taking care of all your needs. Nothing to ask for. Okay? So now, that is called ananda. If you ask ananda, that is ananda. Because no like and no dislike. And that is what is called state of Jivan Mukta. No like, no dislike. I don't want this, I want this. Or gone. Just like you are in the mother's womb. The entire universe is your mother. So like that a Jivan Mukta becomes. If you want to understand what is Jivan Mukta, the way the child is in the mother's womb, the way the child is born, that is the state of Jivan Mukta, ananda. So now you ask, what is ananda? I don't know, I am searching for bliss. What is the definition of bliss? Okay, how is the bliss? The bliss is, remember the nature of the child. Oh, I have forgotten. I don't remember. Then produce two children. Have two children. If you don't understand, have two more. That's why our ancient people told, when the boy and girl, married boy and girl comes, for the woman, they say, Shataputra Vati Bhava. Have 100 children. At least learn from them. To be blissful, to be ananda, which is your nature. Right? Indians have taken this very seriously. We have produced a large number of children, okay, to understand what is divine nature. Divine nature is bliss. Divine nature you can see in full form in the children. Right? And which is your nature. So which is the divine child which is born, not human child. Human child, you converted it. When you are born, you are a divine child. You are Shivasurupa, which is bliss, ananda. Okay? But your parents, your society, convert the divine child into human child as soon as possible. 11 days also they can't wait. Huh? Nowadays, because of the hospital, even before the child is born, they do the scanning and determine the name and have the birth certificate registration, the name is given. Even you don't allow the divine child to be there for one day also. So, when you are born, actually you are born as a divine child. After 11 days, your conversion to human child happens. And simultaneously conversion to the society child happens. Okay? So then now the society child and human child are making too much of noise, and divine child, which has come there, it's also getting confused with these two guys making a lot of noise. And that noise, the society child is always troubled because likes and dislikes. Right? So Amazon.com has sent the package. Like that Bhagavan has sent you in a very, very nicely packaged condition in the womb of the mother. And package is delivered very nicely. And when it's delivered, it's divine child only is delivered because it has come from Bhagavan only. Okay? But after that, damage starts. Right? The full damage starts after that. Everybody wants to use that child and convert it, make it them like. The school teacher wants to, the science teacher wants to make the science child scientist, the physics teacher wants to make the physicist, chemistry teacher wants to make a chemistry, a social teacher, social society, and father wants to make it like the child like himself, mother wants to make the child like a grandmother. So everybody wants to convert the divine child into something. born as a divine child, Shiva Swarupa, grown up as a human child, converted into society child. That's what is your fate. Now the mind has fully developed. The mind has become fully noisy. Kacha, 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 kacha. Because when you are born, there is no noise, no? Born, when you are born, when you are in mother's womb, mind is peaceful. Born peaceful. Now suddenly, mind is full of noise. Everybody wants to pull actually. Everybody wants to pull you in one direction. Right? Huh? So that's the stage. Now, you want to become, go back to divine child. I want peace, I want bliss. So bliss is searched everywhere, everywhere the bliss is searched. Okay? The boy searches the bliss in the girl searches the bliss in the boy, both search the bliss in the job, and they search in the job house. Where is the bliss? Bliss is gone. Everywhere they are searching for bliss. They do meditation, they do spiritual practice, puja, japa, this, that. All religious teachings, everything people start doing because desperate for bliss. Because you know you are born as divine child, blissful. Now you are lost somewhere because of this human child and society child. You are struggling to get it back. Okay. So this is the situation. And this situation, the Shivaratri, the teaching of Shivaratri is the Shiva, the divine child, has nothing has happened to that. Okay, which is you are actually blissful already, now also you are blissful. But too much of noise from this human child and society, human child and society child, your bliss is not recognized. Okay? Bliss is not recognized because too much of noise is happening. So, on the day of the Shivaratri, become aware of your nature as Shivaswarupa. Recognize the divine child in you. It has not gone anywhere. It has not gone back. If the divine child goes back, your body will be dead. The divine child Shiva consciousness is there in you right now. Recognize it. How to recognize that? Okay. Make the human child and society child silent. Society child can be made silent by meditation, by jnana, understanding. Okay. Human child should be kept alert through fasting and being awake. The mind has to be made silent to recognize the divine child in you, which is Shiva Swarupa, which is the bliss. Then you start asking, what is Shiva Swarupa? How is Shiva? Okay, he has jata, snake in the neck. They are all mythological representations of Shiva. The real Shiva is auspiciousness, which is bliss, which is your childlike nature. While coming from the mother's womb, it was blissful. The child which is born is blissful. Sometimes children are born without eyes or ears or something, but still they are born with bliss. While sending, Sadashiva has sent them in the full form of bliss, which is his nature. Okay. So many people, they don't know there is the divine child Shiva is in them. The divine child doesn't become old, it's always ever new, ever young. Consciousness doesn't get old. The human child becomes old, it becomes grows up and becomes old and dies. The society child keeps on crying every day, keeps crying till the human child is alive, it keeps on crying and lives on. The society child, okay, takes some impressions and creates a new body, Jiva. The society child is predominant in your life. If you look at your life, no longer divine child appears, no longer human child appears. It is a society child which is predominant, it is a bully. Likes and dislikes. I want this, I don't want this. It forces on you. if you die without recognizing the divine child in you, what happens to you? You are going back in a damaged condition. The original condition is what? Sadashiva sent you as Shiva Swarupi, blissful. But while going, you are going back in a damaged condition. Even Amazon doesn't accept goods which are damaged. So you sent something and it got damaged. If you send it back to Amazon, it says, no, it's bad usage, send it back. Right? So in that condition, with a noisy mind, you die. Sadashiva, Brahman, doesn't accept it. Go back. Return. Okay, this return is called Punarapi Jananam. Punarapi Maranam. Punarapi Jananam. Punarapi Maranam. Punarapi Janani. Chatare Shayanam. Iha Samsare. Bahu Dussare. Kripaya Pare. Pahi Murare. So, this is the triplet which is. Our problem in life is these triplets. Okay? So, very simple. The society child came from outside. The biological parents gave the body, but the consciousness came from Sadashiva, Shiva Swarupi, which has never changed. Again and again, recognizing that I am Shiva Swarupa, I am pure consciousness, is what is called meditation. And in that process, the noise created by this human child and society child starts reducing, starts impacting you less, and more your divine nature starts manifesting, the blissful nature. So if you die in that blissful condition, you cannot return because you came back, you returned in a original condition. So that is called no more further birth. No punajanma, because you are going back in the original condition. If you go back in damaged condition, you can come back. Why you come back? Again go to the mother's womb, learn how to be blissful, again born as a child, how to be blissful. Oh, you are not learned how to be blissful when you are a child. So you grow up and have a couple of children to understand bliss. That also you didn't understand. Okay, again come back, return. So this is the cycle. So Shivaratri is the day where we recognize our inner self, which is divine child, which is blissful. So not only you recognize that the divine child is in everybody. It is not only you. So as you start recognize that, there's a deep love starts flowing in you. Recognize the divine child in you, there's deep peace. Recognize the divine child in everybody, there's a deep love. Peace and love. Bhakti, which is called prema, and mukti, which is called jnana. They are all synonymous. So this is the journey. And how to recognize the divine child? Very simple. Nanu Nanembudu Nanalla Ideha Manabuddhi Nanalla Sachidanandatma Shivananu Nani Shivoham 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 Ideha Nanalla. Idu Appa Amma Kottadu. It is given by father and mother, body. Mana buddhi, mind and intellect, is not me. It is given by the society. It is a society child. I am the child of the divine, Shiva Swarupi, consciousness. Remember that again and again. And if you want, don't try to imagine how Shiva is. Shiva is blissful like a child. No thoughts, no likes, no dislikes, no wants, no. So if you go back to that understanding, and spend time in meditation in that state, the mind will become free from the noise or mess created by other two children. Okay, and that is a state called Jivamukti. So Shivaratri is remembering that. Now why Ratri? Ratri means night. That too especially night of the new moon, Amavasya, just before Amavasya, which is the darkest day, darkest night, where nothing is there. Okay. So when there is no influence of least trace of the influence of the biological parents or the societal society, which is in the form of mind and body, in a state of samadhi, you experience deep bliss. That is called Shivaratri. Ratri means night. Night for night of what? The night in Vedanta symbolizes ignorance. Okay, night is ignorance. All of us are living in ignorance of what? Ignorance of Atma. But we are fully awake to the world. This is told in Bhagavad Gita. Ya nisha sarvabhutana. Most of the living beings, all the living beings, are sleeping or experiencing the night in the waking condition. They can only recognize the body and the mind and society, which is actually human child and society child. But they cannot recognize the self, which is Atma, which is Shiva Swarupa. Okay? The Shivaratri is ulta. You have a Ratri now. Now you don't recognize the human child and society child. You will recognize only divine child. So that is called Shivaratri. That's why it's called awakening, jagarana. It is the night, but it's a different kind of night. In the earlier night, you are only recognizing the society and the body. Now in this night, you are not recognizing society and body. That's night for you. But you are awakened to the inner self, Shiva Swarupa. And that can happen through contemplation and meditation. Any questions?